Good morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Ridler Studios. I am Jamie, and it is Wednesday. And this is the last sort of full-time week I have in the studio before taking a little bit of time off and then diving into what's the studio going to look like in the fall. So wrapping up the last week of Art of the Altar, we're exploring the direction east this week and its energy of air. And then we're going to do some work on the weekend about activating and tending our altars. And remember, if you want to sign up for classes, you still can. The live portion may be done, but you will have access to all the recordings for an indefinite length of time. It's not like you need to get it done by the end of the season or by the end of the year. I leave these classes up so that you can really enjoy them and take your time with them. But once we hit probably about mid-August, like when I'm ready to launch the new season, all of the classes for this season will disappear. So if you're interested, go on over to openthedoor.ca, click on the Academy, and that's always where you'll see all the classes. I've been having so much fun with classes this year. Also, soon we'll be wrapping up the podcast, but tomorrow I have an interview with you with Jean Oliver. And I have to say thank you so much to everyone who sent me classes that are at her Creativity Network saying, hey, Jamie, I think you'd like this, because that's what connected Jean and me. And we had a wonderful time chatting about what it means to live a creative life and to really stick with it. And I really appreciated so much of what she shared, and I know you're going to too. So be sure to check that out. It's Creative Living with Jamie. It will be live on iTunes tomorrow. And of course, you can always see it at my blog at openthedoor.ca. So the podcast is coming. BTS is going to wrap up next Friday. And I thought what I would do, not this coming Friday, not that soon, but the following Friday, August 4th. And I thought what I would do is come at you live on that Friday. Wouldn't that be fun? And we can hang out together. So next Friday, I will be here at 8:30 a.m. EST. And so you just make sure you're subscribed on YouTube. And if you allow notifications, you should get notice, or just come to my channel. An easy way to get there is creativelivingtv.ca. So last time I went live to Facebook, I think this time I'll try coming live to YouTube, and we will see how that goes. It's always an experiment. One of the things I learn more and more is that you need to have a willingness to risk. You need to have a willingness to experiment in order to learn and grow whatever it is that you want to do. We don't get better at any skill by sitting thinking about it, except for sitting and thinking about it. We can get expert at that. Perhaps you're one. I can be one. But in order to be a better painter, in order to be a better photographer, in order to be a better entrepreneur, a better teacher, we have to risk doing it exactly where we are. And one of the things that helps me with that is to identify a few key things that I feel so confident in. Like, I know that if I get this message across, then I will have done something good. And as long as I get this message across, then I'll be able to feel good about it. So I always look for something in the content that I'm delivering to feel like, okay, as long as everybody learns that taking that first step is courageous and they can do it, then I'll have done something good. And then also something in me. So, as long as I show up and really listen to what people are sharing with me, then I'll have done my job. So one point in the work and one point in myself where I feel like if I guarantee those two things, I can feel good about my efforts. And there are always things that I feel confident in, and there are always things that I think are crucial to the work. And there are always things that I really believe in, that I really believe make a difference. And so that's my advice to you if you are stretching into, let's say, photography. As long as I experiment with the aperture, I'll feel like I did my job today. And as long as I show up and have a spirit of adventure, then I'll feel like I've done my job. So I'm going to combine adventure and aperture. And if I've done that, then I will have moved forward in my photography. So something in the work and something in you that is a focus, a commitment, something achievable and meaningful to you. So that's my suggestion, as well as stepping out and risking and trying and growing. I say this to you with a certain sense of urgency, the kind of urgency I've had ever since my mom passed away, the urgency of knowing that for all of us, life is finite. And so if there's something you want to do, please start. Do it. Try. Get a taste of it. Don't wait. The way you get ready is to do it and to learn as you go. Yes, creating an environment that supports you. Yes, creating risk that you can manage, but doing it. And so there's that reason. That sense of urgency of us only have so much time in our lives. And for me, again, that was inspired by the passing of my mom. But also when I look back over my own life and I think about all the times I felt like I'd missed the boat, all the times like I felt I was too old, like somehow if I had only started when I was 16, if I'd only started when I was 20, if I'd only started when I was 30, that things would have been different. And I'm going to tell you now that whatever age you are this minute, your 10-year from now self, if we are all so blessed and lucky, and I hope we are, to live that 10 years, will look back and say, if only I had started when I was, right? One of my favorite thoughts in The Artist's Way by Julia Cameron is about this, where somebody is talking about learning how to play the piano. And how they're so far behind and they're so old and like they've sort of missed that window of opportunity. And Julia Cameron said, yeah, but 10 years from now, you can still be wishing you were playing the piano, or you can have 10 years of experience playing the piano. So you choose. So I guess I'm inviting you to choose your passion, to choose your desire, to choose your bravery and courage, because it does take bravery and courage. I think one of the things that people often misunderstand about the work I do in the world, and that work is all about helping people find the confidence and courage to express their creativity, to reawaken that creativity, and then to manifest it in the world. And I think because I take what looks like a very gentle approach to this, people think that it is all softness here. And in fact, what I would love people to know, if you were to ask me the question, what do you wish people know about the work that you do, is the reason is that there is so much softness and gentleness here is because the people who are doing the work are so damn brave. And it takes courage to risk your creative heart. It is tender. It is pure. It is love itself. And by that I mean it, there is a deep love for that thing, that precious, precious idea that you want to bring into the world. And there's a huge tenderness around that. And that bravery never ends. And so whether you are somebody who is coming to the canvas for the first time and learning to paint, yay you, you know, or whether you're a seasoned professional photographer and you're deciding to experiment with a new idea that means risking how people see your work, that means, hey, I've established a certain amount of credibility and now I'm going to do this crazy thing and that's a risk. Each of those people lives on that edge of bravery, that luminous edge that is required in order to do true, authentic, and good creative work. The creative work that comes from your deepest heart, that creative work that you're pulling up from the root of you and sharing with the world. And so in this way, all of us creatives, whether we are at the beginning of our journey or the beginning of a new stage or new project, we all experience the same thing, and we need to look at each other and honor and respect the warriorness of what we're doing as creatives, all of us. And that those of us who are braving it, whether we are stepping into that dance class and learning our first flat ball change, or whether we are leading a class for 3,000 people, when we are on the growing edge, we are the same warriors. And we need to honor that with each other. And that's the creativity that excites me. The creativity that is about braving being ourselves, risking sharing our thoughts, our ideas, ourselves with the world, and growing because of it. That shines a light into the world, that light of creative warriorship, and that light of individuality, that light of spirit, that light of, look, you can do this too. I think that's what I'm always, always, always saying to you. Look, you can do this too. So, wow, I didn't expect to speak about that today, but that is what the BTS is all about. You know, trusting the moment and being here with you. And I really, in this, I trust my own heart. And in this, I trust our connection. I trust that something will well up out of me that's tuned in to something that's calling out from you. And I hope that that's true today. I want to say a special thank you to Jeanette. Hey, Jeanette, who let me know that she did the 733 supply set challenge and that it opened up her awareness of the arts that actually are important to her and the ones that are maybe not so much. And that was a joy and a revelation and a really positive thing. So thank you, Jeanette, for trying the 733 supply challenge and also for letting me know how it went for you. I hope this allows you to really dive in with your whole heart to the arts that are calling you. Because there is something magic in there, and that's why you discovered it. So that is it for me today. I'm going to be getting that podcast ready for you tomorrow. I'm also filming Start Creating As We Go with my sister, Susie and Shannon. So we'll have a new episode for you soon. It's the show where we share all the things we're creating and what we're learning along the way. I hope you'll join us for that too. We have our own channel there. It's Ridler Sisters here on YouTube, and I will put a link to that as well. I am cheering you on, creative warrior, and I'm so glad you're here. I'll talk to you on Friday. It is a gorgeous day here in Toronto, so I have opened the windows, and clearly Scout and Shibumi are so glad that I did. I hope you are having a wonderful day, and I hope today treats you beautifully.